Hello again, friends and fans. Raptor here, and welcome to Call to Arms. What is Call to Arms, you ask? Well, it's like a modern-day version of Meta War Assault Squad 2. It combines what you like, probably, of Wargame Red Dragon, that entire series, plus modern combat, and including the modern mods that were included for Assault Squad 2 that were available on the Steam shop and worked on ModDB. According to the description, it says, Call to Arms offers an innovative new look into modern era combat. Initially offering two playable factions with realistically modeled vehicles and heavy weaponry, as well as dozens of firearms and customizations. Command your troops to victory or fight by yourself in the third-person action mode. The base game offers two factions, the United States Army and the Global Revolutionary Movement. Fight in rural areas, factories, railway stations, or in towns to use the environment to your advantage. Cover is everywhere and almost everything can be destroyed. So there you go, that's basically it. It will be supported by Steamworks, and what's really exciting is that because a lot of the popular mods from Meta War Assault Squad 2 that I see, Deplitted XHD, I never even remember how to say his name, but you guys know, the RTS Swedish guy, that's basically what he plays a lot, is the mods for the game, and what is great about Call to Arms is that mod is finally coming to fruition. Though this isn't influenced by it in any way, it's its own standalone version, it will be a separate game that you will have to pay for to buy and get early access to very soon. In fact, I've been hinted by Delta Dude, who is our contact, who actually works for the company, that this is right around the corner, probably literally right now available. So the game, obviously, the options in the game offers quite a few different vehicles. Not only do you have tanks and light technicals, but you also have infantry transport, and infantry combat will be extremely extensive. So for those of you who have always wanted to play a extremely micro RTS game that revolves around squads, Men of War has always been the series for that, but Call to Arms will elaborate on that extensively. You think about smoke grenades and maybe perhaps night vision and thermal goggles, maybe not that kind of stuff, but it is a possibility. Of course, always under grenade, the grenade launchers that are on the rifles, under the rifle grenade launchers are going to be extremely effective here in clearing out sectors. And look at some of these tanks that we have access to. We've got the Humvees and we've got technicals and things like that. In fact, I'm going to show you the Steam page right now. Let's go ahead and pull that up. Here we've got a Jeep and, well, not a Jeep, but a Humvee. I say Jeep because I think of Men of War. But yes, look at that Humvee, how beautiful that is. And obviously, other YouTubers are starting to cover this as well. It's been known since the Men of War Assault Squad 2 beta that this was coming. And here's a nice look at an Abrams right here. Oh, yes. Oh, and here's another side look from it. So since this game has been around for a while, there's other games such as Armored Warfare and some other stuff that I finally plan to cover, as we're finally getting more detailed looks at these games and they're more likely to come out. Look at the nice technical with that Dishka. Oh, and a recoilless rifle on the back as well. Perhaps there'll be some customization in that view. So we also have, oh yes, the global revolutionary movement is definitely going to get that. So it is so nice, by the way, to see other YouTubers who I play with to also be interested in these games as well. So hopefully there'll be some future collabs with them as well. And obviously everybody's excited for this game. So it comes out quarter four, as I had said, very close, very much around the corner. And by the way, if you did get access to the Meta War Assault Squad 2 beta and you did pay for this and back it, there may be a possibility on getting into that. I'm not exactly sure, but I will put links down below to the website. You know, obviously we're looking at some pretty cool footage, some real basic footage, but again, when it comes out, it will be an early access game. So it will be interesting to see. And by the way, a lot of popular mods for Meta War Assault Squad revolve around modern conflicts, and I would really like to see some scenarios created, even more further mods around the Israeli Six-Day War and around ISIS and around those kinds of modern conflicts. That's what we're literally fighting right now. It's interesting to see that games such as Red Dragon and Armored Warfare and even games like Call of Duty really focused around Russia versus the United States, or the East versus the West. But it's really interesting to see games that are going to take on the Middle East, and there's not enough of them. There's not enough games that cover World War I, and there's not enough games that cover modern-day conflicts in modern-day theaters. So hopefully this game will be a deep insight in that. I will get you more information down below. We'll take a look at some maps and stuff like that, and hopefully by the end of this week, you guys get into this awesome game.